Hi, in this video, we'll go over how to edit and save basic incident details. Note that a separate video will cover how to edit incident module information. First, I need to search for an incident to edit it. I'll click on Incidents in the top navigation bar, then click Search Incidents in the dropdown. Here, I can specify search criteria to look for an incident. If you want to learn more about how to use this search feature, check out a separate video we've made that's all about searching for incidents. Right now, I just want to look up some 2020 incident in Virginia. So I'll select Virginia in the Fire Department field. In your case, you would choose the fire department or group that you belong to, and then select the year 2020. Then click Search. I'll choose the first result here, which is an incident with the incident number of 18003. I'll click on the number link to go to its detail page. This page is a long form that's split into several sections, each dealing with the incident's basic information. On the right side, there are navigation links to take you to the different parts of the page, various buttons to perform actions on the incident, such as saving it or viewing validation errors, and a brief history of the incident. I'll go through the page and highlight key parts of the form. At the top, you'll see the incident's key information, which includes the incident's incident number, incident date, exposure number, and associated state and FDID. Since the incident has already been created, most of these fields can't be edited after the fact, so they are disabled. The next section is called Location Type. Here you'll specify important location fields for the incident, such as the incident address type, street or highway, city, state, and zip code. The red asterisk next to each field means that the field is required. If I click into the Incident Address Type field, what's known as a Code Lookup menu pops up. This menu shows a list of options that the field can accept. Simply click on the option that is appropriate and it will be entered into the field. You will see many more code lookup menus throughout this form and even on other pages of eNFIRS. In most other fields, you can simply type the value. Before I get deeper into the form, I'll save the changes I made so far. To do this, I'll click the Save button on the right. If all the incidents fields satisfy the validation rules, then a success message should appear at the top of the page saying that the incident was saved successfully into the system, and no red error messages should appear. The lack of errors mean that the incident is valid. To demonstrate potential errors, I'll go back and clear some required fields and then save again. It still says that the incident was saved into the system. However, we see that there are a few error messages at the top because I left some required fields blank. An incident with errors is considered invalid. At any time, you can click the View Errors button on the right to view all this incident's error messages. The View Errors button does not save your incident, but rather just shows the errors. In the next section, we have the Incident Type Code Lookup field, which determines what kind of incident this is. Depending on the incident type, this form's required fields may change. The rest of the form is straightforward. There are just some text fields, code lookup fields, and basic controls like checkboxes and buttons to assist with filling in the form. Just remember to click Save on the right to save any changes you've made as you go. If you need assistance filling out these fields, consult the eNFIRS 5.0 specification or the eNFIRS Support Center. The last section of this form is the Module Overview. Here you can view all optional and required modules that are attached to this incident. We will go over how to add, edit, validate, and remove modules in a separate video. Underneath the buttons on the right, you can view the incident history. This section includes information like when the incident was last exported, updated, saved, or created, as well as who last saved the incident. Lastly, once you're done with editing and saving the incident, you can click the Back button to go back to the search page. Or you can click the Close button to leave this page and go back to the home page. In this video, we went over how to edit and save basic incident details and view validation errors.